His wounds, his hands, his feet. drenched in tears. They laid him down in Joseph's tomb. The entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still. Sing, oh, praise the name.
And oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will sing your praise. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord.
It's been a whole year since I've seen you guys. Is that joke already old? A little bit? How many of you still have your number? If you don't have a number, wave your hand and we want to give you a number, all right? Trust me, you're going to want to have a number. If you don't have one, hold your hand up. Rogers is going to give you one. If you don't have one, it goes along with my message. Each and every single one of you need one. Don't have a number, keep your hand raised. Roger will get you one. Don't be cheating and taking more than one number. How many of you have ever gone somewhere before and they've given you a number, they've told you to take a number? Okay, I'll explain. How many of you have ever gone to the DMV? Okay. When you go to the DMV, they give you what? That's true, but they give you a number, right? How many of you shop at Publix? Where shopping is a pleasure. If you ever go to Publix and it's a little busy in the meat section, they have numbers that you can take to get some boar's head turkey and all that goodness. But I'll never forget, in college, we love free food, so we would always try and figure out where a Chick-fil-A would be opening. Like, where is the nearest Chick-fil-A opening? Because the first 100 people who showed up got free Chick-fil-A for a year. It's a true story. They still do it to this day. But literally, the word has gotten out so much that now they give you a number and they draw numbers and they pick 100 people, and those 100 people have to stay over 24 hours to get Chick-fil-A for a whole year. So people will camp out in the parking lot at Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A will serve them food. The parking lot is pretty cool. I had an opportunity to try and do this when I was in North Carolina, and I got a number. But to make a long story short, there was 240 people who got a number, and I wasn't one of those 100 who got the opportunity to stay. And I was really bummed. I was extremely bummed. I don't remember my number. I was more upset that I threw it in the trash and I just got out of it. But tonight, we kick off with a brand new series called You Matter. And the biggest thing that I want y'all to know, as God's done what he's done in the life of Alive, and now we're here in 2017, what I want you all to know is that you matter to me, you matter to the student ministry, that you are more than a number to us. So if you're taking notes tonight, the title of my message is More Than a Number. I want to encourage you to take notes. You can't pass a test in school most of the time without taking notes unless you're a genius. If you're going to pass the test of life, you have to take notes. I don't know if you're like me, but I get distracted. I want to encourage you to take notes. But you are more than a number to me. You are more than a number to every single one of your Alive leaders here. That's why they serve, and that's why they love you, because you are more than a number to them. And something that sometimes gets out that I hear sometimes is I hear this, that Hux is all about numbers. So I don't know if some of you have noticed this or not, but over the last month and a half, I haven't posted numbers. The only numbers I've posted are how many people have come to know Jesus and how many people have gotten baptized in the last month and a half. If you were to jump on Instagram, that's the only numbers that I've posted. Because I don't want to go down, and I never want you guys to think that I'm only about how many people can be here on Wednesday night That's not what I want to go down for. That's not why God called me here. Alive exists so that dead people can become alive. You guys are more than a number to me. You're more than a number. Not only are you more than a number to me, but you're more than a number to Jesus Christ himself. And some of y'all need to hear that, because some of y'all feel like you're just a number, that no one notices you. But you're more than a number. But for those of you who have a number, if you can look at that number, and I want to give out some prizes before I continue. So I'm going to call out a random number, and I'm going to give away this little emoji pillow. So if you have the number 51, come up and get this. I see you, Gunner. Here you go. That's okay. The next number that I'm going to call out, I'm going to give out a free snapback. If you have the number 75. Here we go. It's okay. It's okay. The next thing that I'm going to give out is a journaling Bible. Probably one of the most amazing gifts that I can give out. I'm going to call the number 121. There you are. The last number that I'm going to call out, you can only win if you're a guy. I'm not trying to be sexist, all right? But this is the prize, because we had some person drop from Winter Retreat, and they said, I want you to give my spot to somebody else. Absolutely free. Okay? But they're a guy, and I can't stick a girl in a guy's room. Okay? That's why I'm giving it to a guy. If you're the number 23. All right. I got to call it another number. You ready? I'm going to go with 28. Nice. We talk later. If you don't want it, then I'll try to. Anyway, congrats. Draw another number just in case. Just keep your number, and I might call one out at the end. Okay? But I want you to hold on to that. Hold on to that number still, because I'm still going to use it. But listen, these are the numbers that I want to be about. Because this is what God has done in the life of Alive in the fall of 2016. This is what he's done. These are the numbers that I want to be about, and I want to share this with you guys. This is what he's done in the fall of 2016. God has saved 14 students, and there's 19 students who have taken their next step in baptism. Numbers that we want to be about, but not only do I want to be about those numbers, the numbers that should matter the most to me are discipleship numbers. Who's in a discipleship group? Who's in a small group? Who's in a Sunday school? Because those are the things that matter most. Because God has called each and every single one of us to make disciples. So that's why I want to apologize if y'all have gotten that vibe from me over the last 2.5 years that I'm just about numbers. Because I'm not. I love y'all to death, and I want to be about each and every single individual in this room. Because it's not about drawing a crowd. It's about each and every one of you. That's what it's about. I love y'all. I love getting to know each and every one of you. When y'all hurt, I hurt. When y'all are going through something, I want to go through it with you. I care about you. I love you guys. That's what I want to be about. See, Jesus was all about getting to know the individual, even though there happened to be a crowd. So I want to share a story with you. from in Luke. So turn with me to Luke. Luke chapter 19. Please use your Bible apps. Do not be on Snapchat. Don't be on Instagram. If you want to tweet a point, you can. If you see someone on social media, please tell them, put it up. All right, I'm never going to call you out from this stage and embarrass you. But when I read God's Word, God is speaking. When I read God's Word, God is speaking, and there's no one that I would ever want to get in the way of speaking than God. You might have a friend in here tonight who's never heard God speak, and God speaks when His Word is read. God speaks when His Word is read. God is speaking. Whatever you do, don't be a distraction when the Word of God is read. Don't be. Follow along. May I challenge you, carry this around wherever you go. Love this thing to death. Luke chapter 19, verse 1. This is what it says. Jesus entered Jericho. Jericho is a very wealthy city. If you have a little journaling Bible, you want to write in it, I write in mine. No, Jericho is a very wealthy city. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus, a.k.a. Zac. He was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being very short man, he could not. Where my shorties at? Okay. Some of y'all are calling people out big time. All right? He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being a short man, he could not because of the what? Crowd, right? So he ran ahead. He climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, "He has gone to be the guest of a sinner?" But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Lord, look, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is the son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and save what was lost." Zacchaeus, that's the first thing that I want to point out. Zacchaeus was a chief tax collector. He cheated people out of money. He was a rotten scoundrel, if you want to say. But see, he was extremely wealthy. But Zacchaeus wanted something. What did Zacchaeus want? What did Zacchaeus want? He wanted to see Jesus, right? He wanted to see Jesus. He had everything, right? Some of y'all, I just want money. Some of you girls are like, "If I just had a boyfriend." Some of you guys are like, "If I just had a girlfriend." And some of y'all got done from Christmas and you got what maybe you wanted and it still hasn't satisfied you. See, Zacchaeus had everything. He was wealthy. But it wasn't enough. See, Jesus wanted something. He wanted what? He wanted to see Jesus. And each and every one of you, God has placed eternity in your heart. We should want to see Jesus. And when we see Jesus for how good He is, our natural response is to be changed by Him. But he wanted to see Jesus. He desperately wanted to see Jesus. But he was a what? He was a sinner, but what? He was a shorty, right? He was a shorty. Where are my short people at? He was a short. When you're in a crowd and you're short, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Zacchaeus desperately wanted to see Jesus, that he went to an extreme length. See, real disciples will go to whatever length to seek Jesus. Do y'all hear me? Some of you in 2017 are still taking shortcuts to have the fullest relationship with Jesus possible. Real disciples of Jesus don't take shortcuts. They do whatever they possibly can to desperately seek Jesus and to see Jesus for who he is. They don't let sleep get in the way. They don't let people get in the way. See, Zacchaeus could have let people get in the way of him seeing Jesus, but he was like, no, I'm going to get to Jesus. I want to see Jesus for who he is. Is that us? Are we desperately wanting to seek Jesus in 2017? If you desperately want to seek Jesus, the number one thing that would be the most important thing to you is his word. But do you desperately want to seek Jesus? Will you go to whatever height? Because check this out. Zacchaeus climbed a tree, but we already know that Jesus died on a tree. Jesus already went to the biggest length for you. If you want to know who Jesus truly is and how much he loves you, he's already gone to the greatest length for you when he went to the cross. When he took a whipping for you, when he took a beating for you, when he was mocked, when he was ridiculed, when he was spit on. What lengths will we go to for him? What lengths will we go to? Y'all know the song, Zacchaeus was a, and a wheel of man was he. He climbed up in a awesome, okay, so. But he was short, right? I'm talking about tonight that you are more than a number, not only to me and the alive leaders here, but you're more than a number to Jesus. See, check this out. No matter how small you might feel, Jesus notices you and Jesus sees you. See, some of you feel small tonight. Some of you feel like, does anybody care? Does anybody see what I'm going through? And there's one person in this world who truly gets you and truly understands you, and that's Jesus. No matter if you feel short, no matter if you feel small, no matter if you feel insignificant, like Jesus sees you and Jesus gets you. Jesus notices the individual in the crowd. Jesus noticed Zacchaeus. Like, Jesus was walking by the crowd. And you know what Jesus does? What does he do? What did Jesus do? Jesus looked up. Jesus looked up. Let me ask you this. In 2017, how many opportunities are you missing because you're looking down? You still have the mentality of, hey, poor me. Like, man, you won't believe what I'm going through. And there's opportunities in front of you constantly to tell someone about Jesus. And instead of you looking up and seeing people in front of you who need Jesus, you're still looking down. That's what the enemy wants you to do. He wants you to have pity on yourself. He wants you to look down. You can look up. There's something else that the enemy loves to do to distract you from intimacy. He loves you to look down at your phone constantly. For you to be distracted, for you not to see people in front of you who are at school who are still hurting in 2017, who are hurting in 2016. And if he can get you to look down and just go past people, when Jesus didn't just pass by people, Jesus took time to seek people out. That's what he did. How you know that you're more than a number to Jesus and you're more than a number to me? Jesus was walking by, and he looks up in the tree, and what's the first thing that he says? He says, Zacchaeus. How did he know his name? Because he's Jesus. Jesus knows your name. Jesus knows the very details of your life. Jesus knows the number of hairs on your head. And how I try, and try my hardest, how I try to allow you guys to see that you're more than a number to me as I try to intentionally know your name. Sometimes it's extremely difficult. I'm going to even challenge the Alive leaders. When you guys break into Alive groups, they're going to continue to get your name, to know your name, to know more about you. That's the least we can do, is know your name. But Jesus knows your name. Jesus knows about you. You matter to Jesus. You're more than a number to Jesus. He said, Zacchaeus, calm down from that tree. I must stay at your house. Immediately, stay at your house. Jesus wants to be involved in your life. Are you allowing Jesus to be involved in your life? Are you? What I love about Jesus is he's a friend of sinners. See, Zacchaeus was known as a sinner. Maybe you're here tonight and you would consider yourself like, man, I can't matter to Jesus. Like, I feel like I've done way too much. Jesus came for you. It was while we were yet a sinner that he died for us. Like, Jesus is a friend of sinners, and I'm glad for that. Because if he wasn't a friend of sinners, I wouldn't be standing before you right now. But you matter to Jesus. You matter to him. He goes on to say at the end right there, he goes on to say, today is the day of salvation. Today can be the day of salvation for you, and that's the most important numbers that we care about. We care about where you spend eternity. That should be the most important thing that we care about when it comes to our friends, when it comes to people beside us. We hear it a lot. That's the most important thing that we care about. Is one day when we die, you will spend eternity somewhere. We are all sinners separated from God, and Jesus made a way on the cross. He paid for our sins. And if we admit we're a sinner and we believe in him, we will come to know Jesus. We will confess him as Lord, and that is exactly what Zacchaeus did. He said, Lord. He said, Lord. He recognized who he truly was. But this should be our main mission in 2017, which was Jesus' mission right here with the story of Zacchaeus. What does it say, the last verse, Luke 19:10? It says, for the Son of Man came to what? Seek and save what was lost. That's what Jesus is all about. I'm glad that Jesus came to me. This past Christmas, we learned that Jesus came to this earth. If Jesus would have not come to me, I would have never gone to him. But that's how good Jesus is. He meets me right where I am, and he wants to bring me out of my mess. See, Jesus does the seeking, and he does the saving. That's what Jesus is all about. Jesus seeks you long before you ever seek him. Some of you don't understand, but you don't know Jesus tonight. He is truly seeking after you like crazy. Because he knows that you are miserable apart from him because your heart belongs to Jesus. I tell you all this all the time. The only person who can satisfy the human heart is the one who made it. That's the only person. And some of y'all keep running and keep running from Jesus, and he will keep seeking after you. He will keep sending people your way until you come to know him. He just wants you to surrender and turn to him. But how many of you, after Jesus has sought you out, you stop seeking him? May you continue to seek him. But the last point I want to make, you want to know how I know you matter to Jesus? It's because Jesus sought you out. If you didn't matter to Jesus, you would have stayed in heaven. But you want to know how I know someone cares about me? They consistently pursue me. See, some of you all text you and I'll be like, man, I miss you. I haven't seen you in a while. It's because I consistently want to pursue you and let you know that you matter to me, that I care about you. How you know that someone cares about you is they pursue you and they say, you want to know what? Hey, I love you and I care about you. People who don't care about you don't pursue you. But Jesus sought after you. He traveled the furthest. No matter how far you might travel, whether you might go to a different country, you can never travel all the way from heaven to earth like he did. That's a lot of seeking. But tonight, no, you're more than a number. You matter to Jesus. No matter how small you might feel, hey, and he notices you, no matter if you're in the crowd and you're trying to get his attention tonight, like Zacchaeus, you're up here, like, Jesus, notice me. Don't you see me? Don't you see what I'm going through? Jesus looks up and he sees you. Jesus knows what you're going through. And some of you tonight are carrying a burden and he is telling you, give it to me. Some of you are carrying the burden of sin and you've never given your life to Jesus. And you need to give it to him. And he is seeking you, telling you to come to him, all your weary and heavy burden. And he will give you rest, because some of you are restless. And your heart will be restless until you find rest in Jesus. Tonight, would you desperately seek Jesus, because Jesus is desperately seeking you? Let's pray. With heads bowed and eyes closed. Right where you sit. Maybe you're here tonight and you don't have a relationship with Jesus. And you know that Jesus has been seeking you. You know you don't have a relationship with Jesus. And you want to surrender your life to Jesus tonight. I just want to pray for you. So with heads bowed and eyes closed, if you do me a huge favor and you want to say, hey, I want to give my life to Jesus tonight, if you can just slip your hand up and go right back down. Anybody tonight, hold it up loud and proud, the greatest decision you ever made in your life. You're here tonight and say, you know what? I don't have a relationship with Jesus. Anybody tonight, don't want to miss a hand. This is why we do a lot. Maybe you're here tonight with heads bowed and eyes closed and you desperately want to seek Jesus in 2017. You don't want to allow anybody to get in your way, no matter a crowd, no matter what obstacle it might be. You want to desperately seek Jesus and you want me to pray for you. If you can slip your hand up, slip it right back down. Thank you. God, tonight I pray for the hearts of these students. God, I pray ultimately they would see that you matter to them. God, you came not only to spend eternity with them, but to spend every single day with them. And God, I pray that they would see that there is a church, there is a student ministry who cares about them. There's leaders in this room who love them. God, I pray that they would see that. That's why we do a live group. So that they can get to know each other, they can get to know a leader who will love them, who will care for them, and will show them that they matter. God, I pray for that student who is still running from Jesus. God, I pray that they would stop tonight and they would turn to you. God, they would repent. God, I thank you for who you are and that you notice each and every individual in the crowd. God, we love you, and I pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. We want to be a student ministry where every single student is known and no student is alone. That's what we want to be. We want to create a space to where dead people can become alive. But we want every single student to be known and no student alone. That's why we encourage you, stay, be involved in an alive group. That's why we encourage you to get in a discipleship group. But the biggest thing, every student known, you're known by God. He knows what you're going through. He knows if you don't have a relationship with Him tonight. May I invite you, if you don't have a relationship with Jesus, just make your way to the prayer room. Maybe you need someone to pray with. Make your way to the prayer room. You still have that number tonight. What I want you to do, because I want you to truly just block this out of your head. I don't want you to think for a second that you're insignificant to us. I don't want you to think that you feel small to God because you're a big deal to Him. So I'm going to challenge you, just like there's already paper shredded. I want to encourage you, when you go to stand and worship tonight, I want you to shred that number. I want you to shred it just a second. What I mean by that is I want you to rip it up, tear it up. And I want you to believe that God loves you, that God's always out for what's best for you. The cross is proof. The cross will always be proof. But I encourage you tonight as we sing to praise God that He sought after you when you definitely weren't seeking after Him. And He wants to use you in a powerful way this year in 2017. We just desperately need to seek Him. May we be a student ministry who desperately seeks Jesus. But if you don't have a relationship with Jesus tonight, I'm going to be standing over here. I want to encourage you to just go to the prayer room. We're here to celebrate with you making that next step in your life. Or most importantly, that first step and have a relationship with Jesus. Let me pray and we'll stand and worship and you respond how God needs you to respond. Let's pray. God, tonight, we're thankful that we're more than a number to you, that we matter to you. The cross is the biggest proof of evidence that we have. God, I pray we'd be a student ministry and desperately seek you. God, I love you and I pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
We will see you.
Quietly make your way